was the roar from a supercharged Chicago Stadium crowd Sunday night. The reason? Blackhawks 10, Montreal 2. Thus did the Hawks complete hockey's most historic turnaround from last place in the Eastern Division in 1968 and 69 to first place in the Eastern Division in 1969 and 70. No other National Hockey League team can make that statement. The Blackhawks and Boston Bruins both finished with 99 points in a fantastic finish. But hockey deadlocks of this sort are dissolved first in favor of the team winning the most games during the season. The Hawks won 45, Boston 40. And they got a record-shattering 15 shutouts from their man of the hour, rookie goaltender Tony Esposito. Goyette to the blue line, dropping it back to Barrison. Barrison leads to Goyette inside, a shot in the great save by Esposito. Another shot is broken up into the near corner, and Tony Esposito has made a tremendous game-saving play. Tony Esposito, the goaltender for the Chicago Blackhawks, who had an absolutely fabulous rookie year. And in my book, he's here three trophies for this guy. The Vezina, of course, the Calder, and the Hart. Are you shooting too high along that line, Tony?
Well, I don't think I don't know. There's other guys in the league that are just as good as I am, if not better. And I just to be happy. I'm happy I won one trophy. I won the Vezina trophy, and I'm very happy about that. Whatever comes from this, I'm not even worried about or concerned. If it comes, I'll be very happy to accept it. But if it doesn't, I won't be heartbroken.
And, of course, the important thing, and I know the kind of a player you are, you're a team player as a goaltender, the important thing is to win this championship, and we have won the Prince of Wales, and another one coming up, John.
Well, I'm very proud of the players in front of me. I tell you, I've never played with a bunch of men like this. When the season's over, I think we're going to have a May. The season is over, but not over, it's over officially, but not for us because we have playoffs. And I just would love to. I'm going to take the boys out, I think, and throw a little spread for them. They've been great for me, they're great to me. And all I can say is I'm proud to play with them.
Well, they're proud to play with you, Tony. I know that for sure. And again, congratulations on a fabulous season, and good luck to you and all the guys in the cup.
Thank you very much.
Okay. 5 seconds left to play. Barkley played it behind the net. 2 seconds, 1 second. And there it is! The Blackhawks have won. Defeated the St. Louis Blues by a score of 1-0. And Tony Esposito is being absolutely mobbed by his teammates because he has just tied an all-time National Hockey League record for shutouts by a goaltender in one season. He now has 13. Esposito and the Hawks beat the St. Louis Blues 1-0. And what an exciting moment. Harry Lumley had held that record. He came up with 13 shutouts in a 70-game season in 1963 and 54 while playing for Toronto, and Esposito has now matched that. Power play hockey for Detroit. Dale Ralph leads it out for the Red Wings. And he gives to Connolly. Connolly at the right wing, checked by Jarrett, off the near board of the near corner. And Howell puts goal to that far corner. Season as the Blackhawks win it 1-0. The Blackhawks all season long. a man didn't know where the Lightning would strike next.
Mikita skates to the center line. Mikita to the blue line. The Dennis Hall right back to Mikita. Beautiful play. Mikita trying to center. And Dennis Hall was over left. Back to the point. And Bill White. Flash draft. Get a goal!
His 35th goal of the season. White, of course, gets an assist on the play. The goal coming at 5:57.
Martin steals in the New York goal. The veneer board. Dennis Hull, big point.
Down there at the end, we're fortunate to have our two boys with us, Bobby and Brett.
Blink is homesick, and of course the baby he doesn't know about yet.
A memorable moment, a memorable season, and one in which the Blackhawks had to fight for everything they got.
Watch it on the far side at that board. Wayne Carlson trying to throw a couple of punches on the Eric Nesterenko. Nesterenko being held back. He takes a punch from Esposito. Nesterenko and Esposito now. Nesterenko with the right hand to the high forehead. Up Nesterenko and they pile up on the board. Two separate fights going. The Carlson fight has ended, but Esposito and Nesterenko are still going at each other. And the two linemen are trying to break them up as Bobby Hull is holding on to Wayne Carlson now off the far board. And they all pile up as things settle down. Gloves and sticks all over the ice. Esposito came on to hold off Nesterenko, and then no sooner did he hold him off than he took a right-hand swing at him. I don't believe that Nesterenko ever did get a good punch in on Wayne Carlson or Phil Esposito. Let's go down to Lou Boudreau and find out how he saw it.
I saw it the same way as you, as Esposito pulled Nesterenko away from Carlson, and Esposito thinking differently than what Nesterenko was thinking, actually let him have two good right hands. Nesterenko was, of course, protecting himself against Carlton, not Esposito.
Dallas Smith is being checked by Cliff Coral in the near corner. Derek Sanderson comes out of the play, and Dallas Smith throws a right hand at Coral. No penalty. Now Magnuson getting involved in it. Dallas Smith. Now Derek Sanderson.
People figured that the rookies wouldn't stand up in the stretch run, but these kids certainly all came through. Pender, Coral, Schmurr, when I used them, Magnuson, Esposito, they were all terrific. Esposito just had a fantastic year. He kept us in hockey games time and time again with his great goalkeeping and the record that he got this year. I just didn't think that was possible in modern day hockey.
Awaiting the Stanley Cup showdown, Chicago versus Detroit. This show has been produced by Jack Rosenberg and directed by Jack Minovich. All of us salute the Blackhawks, alive and well and living in Chicago.
Although the Blackhawks did not win the Stanley Cup in
1970. All right, to the center line, leading the Mikita over the blue line in the slot. To the right side, and Pappin, they shot, and Dryden makes the save, and nobody wears, knows where the rebound went. And it came to the near board as Dennis Hall was put down. Set it off the far board. Mikita with a shot, a save, and no rebound. Back to the blue line. Stapleton with a shot, no rebound, another shot, another rebound. And a goal! putting on the brakes, continues to control, looking for someone to lead to, gives it to Jimmy Pappin at the blue line, trying to break it into the slot. He has put down the solid check. Mikita picks up the puck. He's in front of the net.
Goes over to the Chicago bench to get a new stick. Rajon Hull for holding at 8:46. A 3-3 hockey game. And Gotti on the ice along with Chico Mackey, Jimmy Pappin, Bobby Hull, and Pat Stapleton. Face off outside the hockey line, the near side of the rink. The draw off the near board, taken by Angotti and Bobby Hull. Intercepted at the blue line by Mahovlich. Mahovlich on the left wing. Mahovlich is shot. There we go.
Richard was was wide open at the Hawk blue line. He came in on the left wing, past Magnuson. He moved in front of the net after drawing Esposito over, and he poked it home. And the Montreal Canadiens have the lead over the Chicago Blackhawks, 3-2. Mikita to the blue line. Mikita moving to the slot, dropping into Coro. Coro is checked from both sides, and it's off the side of the net. Now Dennis Hull digs for it, but stolen away by Beliveau. Less than 2 minutes to play in regulation time. Possession to the Canadiens. Up to center ice. And Jerry Pinder waiting. The long slap shot is deflected by J.C. Trombley into the far corner. And Trombley recovers and throws it around the near board of the Canadiens. Out to center ice. Chico Mackey digs for it. Rajon Houle has it on the right wing. Rajon Houle moving into the slot. A shot and a save. No rebound. Hooked away by Stapleton. And Stapleton off the near board. Leads it ahead to center ice to Dennis Hull. To the center line of Chico Mackey. At the blue line on the left wing. Chico Mackey leading into the slot and deflected off of Ferguson. Stapleton behind the net, slip falls down. 32 seconds left in regulation play. The Hawks net is empty. Stapleton coming out of his own zone to center ice and led to Bobby Hull at the blue line. Stolen away by the Perrier, taken by Cornwallier. A long shot is off the mark of the open net and picked up by Bill White into the near corner. Bill White digging for it off the near board to Bobby Hull. Bobby Hull and Mikita at center ice. Mikita to the blue line. Whining, taking the slot shot, meeting in front of it. Tim Martin couldn't get his shot away. 5 seconds left. 4, 3, 2, 1. Jimmy Pappin, a long shot, and there it is. That's all she wrote. The Montreal Canadiens have defeated the Chicago Blackhawks and are the 1971 Stanley Cup champions. They are absolutely wild. They have gagged their goaltender, Ken Dryden, as well they should. All the players on the Canadian bench swarming around their goaltender and now around their coach.
Professional sport.
A slap shot that's saved by the Jordan.
Bobby. Campbell in the slot. Bobby Hall.
far corner. Here's Chichero to the far side. Out to the hot blue line. Coral flying to the center line. The blue line. A slap shot. A goal!
Taken by Edistrand, and he has it right back and away to pluck it away in front.